Good morning, Jason. Good morning, everybody. Zhao Guodong breaks off first frame of this second and final session. And probably a little bit to think about overnight. He won the first two frames of this match and would have been very disappointed to go three frames behind at the end of that first session. Think maybe Ding Junhui has brought the back of him now, Alan?
Yeah, it's a good point you make, John, because he started very strong, Zhao Guodong. 80-odd the first frame, 50-odd to go 2-0 in front. But the heavy scoring dried up. And what a starter for Ding Junhui, right out the blocks. How still he stayed in that shot.
Pretty good, 69% long pot success. I always think if you're round about the mid-60s, and the reason I say that, because a lot of the long pots are played as a shot for nothing. Every other aspect of the game, I'm looking for 90% or above, and I'm certain the players are. He's just got a little bit of work to do here with the cue ball. Got this red to the right centre, but got to control the cue ball, got to find the gap to get back on the black.
Nine.
Couldn't have played it better. Wow, our optimistic director already telling you. Two reds. This is the second black. But whether he can get back on the black now or not is another matter.
16.
In this, he's running to red. Just don't take your eyes off the pot. Trust the luck with position. Well, he found a nice path to get through. Now, he won't be playing the black, and the reason he won't is because that red just below the black near the top cushion, that will interfere with his position. Pink's the better option.
Yes, already, John, that's two tricky little reds he's knocked in. He doesn't normally have to play that many of those. His cue ball is so tight.
23.
Keeps it under close orbit. He really looks in good touch just early on here. The hallmark of his game is Ding Junhui, his positional play. It's up there, well, at least as good as anyone else in the game.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. And he's got some lovely touches around the pink and black, hasn't he? You know, that red he played before he played the pink. You know, he judged it perfect to kiss off the second red. But not for the 24. First time in our commentary career, we give him the dreaded commentator's curse.
Pink ball.
Just one small piece of information for our viewers is that the cushions have been recovered 24. Overnight, so that's good news for the players. Just after 3 days, I think that's a good thing. Back in the day, 10, 15, 20 years ago, I think the tables were only covered once up until the semi-finals, or recovered once.
Pushed the cue ball to the top cushion, felt that the red along the top cushion thing would refuse, and he's correct. But as always, when you're in this situation, Zhao Guodong, well, he could do with the start he had at the beginning of this match. These first couple of frames, very, very important. You feel if Ding Junhui was to get the better of him in the early exchanges, then there'd be no way back. Ding Junhui won't be frightened of the winning line when it starts looming. Not played that well. He's left Ding a couple of tempters here to the left middle.
Yeah, the one on the pink spot line. I just wonder if he could play it screwing it back. There's a shot to nothing. In fact, he's playing the low one, and that is also a shot to nothing. Big shot, this. Oh, that's straight in the heart of the pocket. What a shot. What?
Yeah, he played a similar sort of shot in the first session. And he came out of two cushions. And we know how tight these middle pockets have been playing, but if you hit them right in the middle, nothing's going to stop them going in. So just the start that Ding was looking for here.
Eight. Nine. 13. Fourteen.
Just okay. It's all about missing the red near the top cushion. Just overdone that slightly. The red in the middle of that
21.
Cluster of five obviously goes to the right corner. Just 23 points away now from getting to the snooker's required stage. 51. And played that well.
22.
It's hard to see him making a mistake now. Gonna miss the green on the way back. He played it absolutely inch perfect.
27.
Yeah, you have to say, John, you always marvel, don't you? His cue ball control is
28.
Well, it's exemplary. It's such good touch with it, as you said as well. But when you're playing against him, you just think, when's this guy gonna run out of position? He just always seems to land a correct side of the next shot.
33.
Even dropping this through for the black to the opposite corner. Just so precise.
34.
Again. Just makes it so much easier, doesn't it?
After this black, just looking for one more red to get to the snooker's required stage.
41.
Yeah, and I was only saying yesterday that it seemed at times that he didn't like playing at the Crucible, but certainly his record over the last few seasons. I thought his semi-final match last year against Mark Selby, which he just lost out on, was one of the classic semi-finals.
47.
And prior to that, the year before, he lost in the final. Well, the red's not gone in, but I don't think there's any way Zhao. Well, he may come back to the table only because it's the first frame of the morning. No thoughts of winning it. 71 points behind, with just 59 remaining. But a little bit of table time won't go amiss for the battle ahead.
But yeah, the point you make is Spot on, John. Is Ding Junhui now? He's a time served, almost. I don't know if you'd call him a veteran, but he's been at the Crucible now for so many years. Totally comfortable out there. As you say, last couple of years losing only to the champion, the eventual champion, Mark Selby. Seen a little interview actually pre-tournament from Ding, and he made a statement in it that I thought was quite interesting. He said, I believe I'm the favourite going to the Crucible this year. I think 2 or 3 years ago it's not something he would have said, but he obviously fancies the job.
Well, you can't be a little bit of confidence. And he's also got a good following now. He reacts with the audience and they enjoy him, and he gets a tremendous reception when he comes in. And as Rob Walker introduced him as the Yorkshire Dragon. But, I think the snooker public in particular have really got a soft spot for him. Well, there's a double that wasn't really wanted. As I say, but I don't really think he's got any thoughts of winning this frame, just wants a bit of table time. He's certainly no thought of winning it now. So
blue ball.
Let's practice a long blue.
Yep, okay. Thiago Dong, one frame.
And he's turned to referee Brendan Moore. I don't know why he didn't turn to Ding Junhui, but he's conceded to the referee. I assume that means that Ding is now 7-3 in front.